Okay, so it is 6:05 and we are good to start. For today's session, we have Yuvraj Gurjar with us. Yuvraj sir is a macro photographer and mentor for Tamron India. He has been in this field for more than 3 decades. Yuvraj sir has also won many prestigious international awards, including National Geographic Traveler, highly honored award by Windland Smith Rice International, and much more. Today, Yuvraj sir is going to talk about macro photography with flash and how these flash can be used creatively. So, without spending much time, I hand over the platform to you, Yuvraj sir. And for the audience, if you have any questions, please keep them for the end, where we will have our Q&A session. Thank you so much. Over to you, Yuvraj sir.
Good evening, everybody. As already informed that I am doing macro photography for quite some time. Basically, I started with bird watching, and then slowly I attracted to this smaller fauna, which was and which is neglected for many concern. There are no books available, there are no media available. But when the digital era started, particularly in the sense of internet as well as the digital photography, digital cameras, so the photography boomed, and the all say amateurs or the interested people started venturing nature along with their whatever show camera. It might be, say, compact camera, it might be bridge camera, it might be digital SLR, or even these days a low-end or high-end smartphone. Because every particular this gadget is equipped for macro photography. Only thing you should know how effectively you can use your camera or your smartphone for the macro photography. Now everybody is say specifically interested in wildlife photography or nature photography. Maybe it is mammal photography of say tigers or elephants, or maybe the bird photography. But then there are say specific areas or specific forests that you need to visit. Plus there is a specific time or specific season you have to go for your wildlife or nature photography. Suppose if you want to shoot say tiger, so in monsoon all the forest, forget about this COVID area. I am eliminating 2020. I am talking till 2019 and then 2021 onwards. So every monsoon, the big forest, the tiger projects, the big national parks or sanctuaries will be closed for monitoring and the breeding of the animals. So you cannot basically enter in the forest for your photography. So you have to wait. But macro photography is just such a genre that you can do even on your society campus, your terrace garden, wherever the village outskirts or city outskirts, any city garden also, I mean a public garden, and you can see a variety of butterflies, dragonflies, wildflowers, various insects like dragonflies, ants, bees, the pollinating insects, and so on. So you have to just capture these kind of insects or these natural beauties in your camera, whatever gear you have. It might be a high-end mirrorless camera or digital SLR equipped with a pure macro lens, or it might be bridge camera with a macro mode or super macro mode, or even with your tiny and very compact but very useful smartphone. Now, particularly our today's topic is how you are doing photography effectively, rather macro photography effectively with flash photography. Frankly, monsoon is a prime season for macro, and post monsoon season also, the month of say October, November, December kind of thing. Of course, it depends on the area you are visiting. If you are going to northeast like Assam, Mizoram or Meghalaya, the season changes, and say at least around 8 to 9 months are favorable there because of heavy rainfall. But if you are talking about Maharashtra, Western Ghats, so the monsoon and post-monsoon months are very good for, or rather fruitful for macro photography. But at the same time, our Indian climate, our Indian light is not that sufficient for macro photography. Either you have to carry tripod and then you have to perform macro photography, which is very cumbersome, very tiresome, and very difficult, because maybe the snakes and frogs are wriggling on the ground, butterflies are flying at a height of say 3 feet to 3 meter, some beetles, bugs are flying at say 1 meter length, few tree snakes are having bronze back or wine snake on a say 1 meter height. So how do you adjust your tripod, which is very difficult? And when you are shooting some insect, you might see another beautiful insect next to it, or the another reptile next to it, and then adjusting the tripod legs will be very cumbersome in the actual field. And when particularly it is a monsoon, when it is a drizzling, or it might drizzle anytime, so that time it is very difficult to get the appropriate light for your photograph. So for this, I personally prefer a macro photography along with a flash. Whichever flash you prefer, or rather you have, either it is inbuilt flash or it is a overhead flash, maybe it is a hot shoe mounted flash, or you might have a specialized flash for macro photography, just like ring flash or twin flash or whatever. We will see those types of flash particularly we use in India, and which are easily available for photography. Now, why the flash is required? So, first thing I already told you that our Indian light and particular monsoon light is not sufficient for the macro photography. You will not get crystal clear, sharp images. Either you have to boost your ISO very much, but then you will notice the grains or noise. If you are not equipped with very high-end or full-frame digital SLR or mirrorless, so your low-end bodies will also create noise. So whatever equipment you are using, if you use a flash for performing your macro photography, it is very much essential and required for your creating a crystal clear, sharp images to show your viewers. Now again, there is one point I want to mention, that for what you are doing your macro photography. Suppose if you are just documenting the insect or reptile or frog, whatever, then flash might not be essential for you, because if this is only a record shot, or you want to just to show that animal or butterfly or insect, whatever, to your viewers or for your documentation. But when you club your wildlife or nature for photography as an artistic term, so you create your photograph or image from the point of view of artistic performance, it is not a documentation for your biodiversity records. So if the photography as an art come in your macro photography, then you have to play with your light. Now your light, the natural light or ambient light, is already less or not available for that particular hour of photography. Then you have to boost it with whatever kind of flash you are using, either one flash, two flash, inbuilt flash or whatever. So it will create a drama. You can create a drama on there itself in that particular field, and then you create your image. This is the basic thought behind the creative light photography. In macro photography, you have to create a drama. Suppose if you are going for a sit play or a drama, so there are so many light placed on the actors on the top beam, and they, depending on the scene, they will focus, they will snoot, they will perform various light, then they will put a gel filters, and you will get a light effects also. Of course, in nature we will not perform light color effects on that. But then we will perform various angles of the light, various frequency of the lights to create drama. So instead of talking much, we will try to see some photographs, and then I will try to explain why the flash photography, and then why the flash photography creatively used in our macro photography. So let's share the screen. Just inform me when you are, rather if you are not able to see the images. Are you able to see the image?
Yes.
So now it is full screen. So now you can see the Derbidi bug. It is a variety of plant hopper, and the spider, jumping spider, is approaching for kill. But then I have managed the iridescence on its wing through the throwing of the flash, and then it is bouncing back with a particular intensity. And these are the normally seen opaque or transparent wings, now glistening with various colors. So this is a particular use of flash in a particular angle. The flash is normal. Using the perfect angle gives you these kind of images. So that's why this particular image is creatively done. So now also here with the higher aperture and a use of flash, and as there is a flash, so I can go up to a certain amount of depth of field, say higher aperture, say F11 or F16 or F22, then I can able to capture the spider as well as the entire insect also creatively. If I am not equipped with the flash, if I want to shoot this insect or this particular image with a natural light, the aperture should be very shallow, say F4 or 5.6, and then I will not get such a detailed information in my image. So that's why the effective use of flash is very much essential in macro photography. That how creatively you can do, that is another thing. Now, when I am talking about the creative use of flash, so this particular image is clicked at Kazianaga. This is not a flash photography, but sometimes you have to use your photography creatively using artificial lights. Now here I have used a UV torch, ultraviolet torch, to illuminate this millipede which is glowing fluorescently. So here a flash light is not used, a torch light, and that too particular ultraviolet UV light is used, and then you can see the image here. So you have to use this light creatively. Same here, every scorpion in the world glows in ultraviolet light. So you can go any forest in the world, and if you see a scorpion in the night, and if you are equipped with the ultraviolet light, then you can see such kind of image. Okay, so these are the images which can be used ultraviolet light, and then you can definitely enjoy their nightlife in a wild. Somebody is pointing at the images. Can annotation can be off, so there will be no dots or arrows on the screen. This image is clicked at Kurk. This is the largest wrinkled frog of India. Now, the beauty of this image is this is clicked underwater. The camera is normal. Camera is normal digital SLR. The camera is not underwater, but the object is under the water. I have used flash in such an angle that it will emit light to the underwater subject. It will illuminate the subject. So this way you can perform, because most of the frogs are nocturnal. You have to do night trails in the night, and then if you find such subjects like frogs, you have to use flash to eliminate those beauties. So basically, how to use that creative light is very much important. Now here I will tell you why the creative light system is essential, and which look better in the field. Now this is a normal flash photo of a spiderlings, newly hatched spider babies. Now the photo is sharp, you can see the spider babies, you can see they're all 8 legs. Even if you zoom the thing, then you can see their eyes also. Even if you can see the glowing spider web also. So this is a good macro image. You can all clear and well lit. But then still, it is not dramatic. To create a drama, you have to use a light in particular direction. Now, same image, I have used flash from the both the side, left and right. Now you can see the body yoke, because those spiders are newly hatched. You can see the more glowing of the spider web, and you can see the drama. Now you can see this image again, same image, and now you can see the drama. So here you can use your flash creatively, and then you can create a drama. Now again, think that if a person is a purely biologist and he want to do a documentation, then this image is good enough for him. But if you are using your image as a photography, as an art, then this image is more important, because here you might not find all the features of the insect, but here you can feel the drama. So this is more important. This image I clicked in Karnala Bird Sanctuary. This is very common but very beautiful looking cup mushroom, hairy cup mushroom. Normally a pinkish or yellowish or orangish in a shape. So here you can see the macro image pretty detail. You can see the hair, you can see the even insect inside the cup, you can see their formation, all that. So this is a good image, a good documentation. But then again, there is no drama, or you have to create a drama. So I placed one flash behind the same hairy cup mushroom, and then you now see the details. It is literally like a glowing, the light is coming, then there is a 3D effect, then there is the shadows and there are highlights. So again, see this image, this is good for documentation, good macro image, but there is no drama. And in this image, you can see that, see, there is a drama. You can see the glow, you can see the lighting, you can see the 3D-ness, you can see the depth, which is very much important in your macro photograph. This is an endemic big red snail from Coorg, endemic to Western Ghats, Indralaya Ampulla. Here also you can see the antenna of the snail, the red body, the mucus, and even the moss. It is glowing because I have kept one flash in front of its head, and the light is coming, passing from the left side of the image. So the body and the head, which is red, is illuminated. So these kind of image you can create in a field itself. Okay, so that you have to think before you are creating this image, that how I can place my flash, how I can create a drama in the field, and how I can glorify the beauty of this already beautiful animal in your image, which is already beautiful, but you can glorify the habitat, you can glorify the entire scenario in the field, and then you will get a good creative image. Here again, here this is Amboli bush frog clicked in Goa. Here the torchlight is used against the light. Here this the male is croaking in the night, and one of my friend is holding the torch behind the frog around say 6 to 8 feet, and when it started croaking, I clicked from the front side of the frog, whereas the light is passing behind the frog. Now you can see even the blood vessels on the croaking balloon, even its body, and you can see the star shape in its glitter in its eyes. So this can be created with a multiple lighting system, even with your flash or your various light source. Here I want to mention is that flash is not only the light source. Whatever the I have already shown you the images of UV torch, you can have a normal LED torch also. These are very much good torch, bright torch are available in the market. So you can use those small tiny torch to create the drama in the field, particularly when you are going for a night trails. So you can create a drama. That flash, that particular torch is used for your viewing the object also, as well as it will create a drama for your photography also. Here, this is shuttlecock mushroom. There is an ant on its one of the thread, and I have again put one flash behind the mushroom, and you can see the glow. So this you can create in the field. The same Idrella ampulla snail, big one. It's really big, around 5 to 6 inches. Now I have created front flash plus black flash. So I use two flash here, and then you can see the black shell shining plus the red soft body. Even you can see the eyeball in its antenna. So here you can show the details, show the color to your viewers. This image was clicked in Goa in Bonla Wildlife Sanctuary. This is Udi Chirayat. And I have placed flash from the top of the flower, and then you can see the illumination. You will get the black background or diffuse background, and then you can see the colors brightly. So it's just like your model photography. There is a beautiful model, and then you place various lights in your studio, and then you illuminate. So this kind of thing, that here the model is the beautiful this Udi Chirayat flower, wild flower, which normally blooms in this particular season, post-monsoon, September, October. And then you can have this beautiful color captured on your image with the appropriate flash lighting. This image was clicked in Agumbe. Here the cicada is emerging. You can see at the top there is an empty shell where the life cycle begins, and the shell is spread, and the adult insect is crawled out, and it is now drying its wing. So that's why it is coming in the night, and you can see the overall green wings, transparent wings. After it dries, then it will be opaque or transparent. So this is the night scene. So this is a normal macro image with say flash fired normally. So this is a normal image. So you can see the entire wings and the empty that cast mold. Here, this was I clicked last year in Kul. Here, same thing is happening. Only thing, the lighting is different. My friend is holding torch behind 8 feet, and you can see the blue light passing from the wings. So here it is front lit, and here it is a back lit. So here you can create a drama. Here you can even see the green leaf. It is illuminated. You can see the empty shell. It is illuminated with the light. This is bamboo pit viper. This is not a flash image. I have kept torch below the head of this bamboo pit viper, and only it's the rim of the head and the eyes are popped due to the backlit of the torch. Here flash is not used, but the torch light is used for creating a dramatic image. Of course, this is very tedious job in a field, because this is a venomous snake. Then the snake is moving, so the torch glow is not appropriate. If you keep the torch, meanwhile the snake moves its head to different direction, and it's very difficult. So it's a series of attempts, and then one of the attempt is little bit successful, and this is one of that successful attempt. Here, this is again I have clicked with flash in a foggy morning. I was in a wooden JNP tour and for birding, and it was a foggy, so the birding was not possible. So I was doing macro photography. So this is a spider web studded with the natural dewdrops form. Now I have to illuminate those dewdrops. So I fired a flash, front flash, and then with a high I will get the entire depth and the entire drop illuminated just like a pearl. So this is one scenario, say one type of light. Yeah, so this particular image was captured with the use of flash. So every particular drop droplet on a say spider web was illuminated with the help of flash. The same image, or rather same scene, I have clicked without use of flash. I have kept the gloomy sky as my background, and then I have clicked same image. So you can see there is a two different thoughts behind this image. So this is with flash and this is without flash. So same object, you can create multiple effects depending on your whatever thoughts or whatever your thinking process behind this image. So you can perform your photography depending on that and whatever the equipment or the lighting setup you have. Now I will show you a series of source scale wiper. This is a source scale wiper clicked with a normal flash and front flash. So no, this is just a documentation shot, the head of source scale wiper. Yeah, this is again say front lead image or normal flash used for say documentation, nothing say creative. Of course you can see the details, you can see the depth, you can see the eyes, and you can see the snout and the actual keel of the snake skin. Now here I have placed two different flash, and now you can see the drama in the image. Same snake but with a different light. So this is the third image. Then this is the fourth image. You can see the different lighting. So single snake species, of course those are individual different snakes, but the same species, but you can see the lighting differently. So here you can create drama depending what kind of image you tend to show your viewers. So that is purely up to you, because when you have clicked the source scale wiper say first year, so what you will do for a next year, what you do with the third year, what you will do on a fourth, fifth, sixth year. So you have to creatively think behind the image that yes, I will play with the, because the source scale wiper normally the color or the morph will remain same. So this is basically Ceropia fantastica. This is a normal photo with a normal flash just for documentation, because this is my first ever record, this is first ever time I have seen this in a while. So I have clicked this image with say green background and whatever the tentacles, but then when you go again and then when you try to create something out of it. So same flower, now you can see the lighting, because particularly no other Ceropegia is having these red tentacles. They have the single, the flower or the bunch of flowers, but so you have to illuminate this feature. So I have created this because now here every focus is on the flower itself. Nobody is looking at that red tentacles. Whereas here, all the focus is gone on the red tentacles. So here you can create such a system or such a story behind your image that this can be done. Again, this is the backlit image. I have fired a flash against these frog eggs. The frog babies are really developed and they are ready to hatch, and they will fall down in a flowing stream. And I have fired a flash behind the leaf of this, where this holding or stick the frog eggs. So you have to use this creatively. If I have clicked front, so it will be a jelly like substance and there is a reflection, and then definitely there will be these frogs. But here it is looks like a little bit dramatic. Of course this is not used for science, because here it is dramatic, you cannot see the details of the frog eggs or something. But this is more into for art form in photography. No, many people say that flash photography is a flat photography. Flash photography, you will not get the real colors. Of course, in digital photography, no camera, whether it is Canon, whether it is Nikon, whether it is Sony or Fuji, no camera will give you the exact natural colors. You have to tweak in your post-processing. If it is a flash photography, definitely you have to tweak it more. But then you have seen that specimen in the field. You have seen the natural colors. You have to match those colors and you will get. But aisa nahi hoga ki aapne image le liya aur directly post kar liya. Ya directly aap usse sochte ho ki yes, mujhe naturally waise hi color dikhenge ya milenge jo maine nature mein dekhe tha. Aisa normally nahi hota hai. You have to tweak in between for post-processing. Post-processing. It is not that you have to master in your Lightroom or Photoshop or any other software. You have to tweak it in between. This is a golden tortoiseshell beetle clicked in Amboli. This is clicked in Coorg. This is Mayfly. You can see the iridescence on its wing. So you have to create this with a particular angle of your flash or angle of your light. Again, these are the wild flowers which blooms in first showers, lilies. So this is clicked in Sanjay Gandhi National Park, Yaur. So it is back illuminated. You can see the flower. Those are the ground flowers. So those are very tiny, say 2-3 inches in totality. You have to place the flash accordingly and then you can illuminate the yellow pollens and the petals and all that. Even you can illuminate their stem as well as the leaf. So you have to place your flash accordingly and you have to create a drama. Similarly, this is very common curcuma flower. Everybody who is going for a nature dress have seen this in any forest in Maharashtra. So this is very common flower, but then you have to create some drama. So you have to create some lighting setup and then you have to manage that image, how you can beautifully showcase to your viewers. Again, this is very say common snake in Goa and Karnataka. This is hump nose speed viper. This is front taken image, but the flash is placed at both the sides. Now you can see the light in its eyes. You can see the little bit the upward turn hump and the color of the snake. So this is one image. This is again not a normal image. Creatively light is used. This is further used from the top. You can see the glowing edges. You can see the head angles, acute angles and all that, the eyes popping out. So this you can create while in your field, if you are equipped with good flash or flash systems. Now I will show you some images which is purely clicked at my home while the lockdown. I am still at lockdown, not going out for my nature on macro photography. This is clicked in my home with the use of my flash. So here a baby small tiny lynx spider. Now it is illuminated with two flash systems. So you can see the opaque semi-transparent its legs. You can see the bokeh or the raindrops pollen of the leaf. So you can create the drama. So it is very much possible if you have equipped with a good lens, good camera and a good lighting system, plus your vision. Your vision is extremely important. Your hardware doesn't stop your vision. So you have to think differently, and which is abnormally rather. So taking normal photos is you are doing for so many years, but thinking something different is now much more required. Same spider on a Gokarna flower. Now you can see the lighting. Again, these are my home images, lockdown images. this is Sadafuli flower. Naturally, raindrops stay, and then there is a Asian ant mantis on its very tiny mantis. Now you can see the glow, you can see the lighting, you can see the reflection in the raindrops. Same individual praying mantis on a say Gulbakshi flower. Now see the lighting. Now this is front lit image. This is sideways lit image. This is backlit image. You can see, I am not sure how much you can able to see clearly, but you can see that the baby mantis is cleaning its leg. So this is purely black backlit plus low key image, particularly scale down the intensity of the light. Here again, same flower, same mantis, but light is used differently. Now, how these images are created? Again, this is my most loved snake, hump-nosed pit viper from Goa. Now, how this image is created? So you can see there is a glow behind the tail. So you can definitely tell that there is a light place there. You can see the glow in the front of head. So there is another light place at here. So this is the snake, and all these people were shooting the snake. This is Nature Nest resort in Goa, Molem Bhagwan Mahavir Sanctuary next Rajan. So this is the entire scene, but I don't want that coconut tree or a banana tree in my images. So I focus on a extreme close-up of the snake with making the background black with higher aperture, higher depth of field, and placing the face. So you can create a drama. You can create your own stage. You can even use of these green moss. Now you can, you can see this green moss on the rock. And then you can see here, it is illuminative. So every pose, whatever the possible things are there or habitat, you can create with your lighting system. This clicked in Sindhya rainforest in Sri Lanka. There is a spider in between those two flash, and I am using my image with wireless flash system. Now this is the image. So you can see the light source. One is from left side, one is from left side, right side. Now you can correlate the image. If you see carefully, there is a spider in between those two tiny flash. And this is the image. So you have to create that drama. Now again, this is the same result, different year. There are six. There are six flashes, but frankly, I am using only two. Those are from my other fellow photographers, because this is a venomous snake, so they cannot go near. I don't allow them to go very near. So I place flash for them, and they fire wirelessly. My flash are with the two white socks. You can see those are my flash, which I am using with my camera. And now this is the image. One tiny fruit fly landed on the hump-nosed pit viper. So I immediately shifted my focus from the snake's eye to the fly eye, and I have clicked this image. Now you can imagine I am shooting this image, the snake, the flash setup, immediately shifting the focus from snake eye to the fly eye. And then this was image I have what's normally shooting before the fly was sitting on the snake head. So these are the images I want to show you how creatively you can use your flash in field. So these are some images are homemade, so you can control environment. Some images are really in the wild, so there is no help available there. All the wild places, so there will be all mud and all the water flowing in purely wild places, sanctuaries of the Maharashtra or whatever. So you can still create the magic in those forests. Now, what kind of hardware? Rather, I am talking about the flash system. So this is a Sigma DG 140 flash. So this is a pure ring flash. It fits on a lens, so it will throw light in front of the nearest point from the, your lens, and the control can be on a hot shoe with a spiral cord. So you will get all the TTL lighting through this flash. So this is one light setup. Then this is a Venus flash. There are twin flash, plus there is a center, there is a torch. So it will illuminate your subject, because many times when you are doing a night photography at night trail, your subject is not illuminated, so your lens cannot focus, because for focusing you need some amount of light, and flash will fire when actual shutter is released. So there is a torchlight kind of thing provided here in this flash, so it will illuminate your subject, so your lens can be focused on the properly on the subject, properly on the head, properly on the eyes, and then actual flash firing will be possible. So this is Venus twin flash. This is Yongnuo a flash for Nikon and Canon, which is equivalent to Canon MT24, very cheap, approximate 15,000-16,000, very effective. It fits on a say like this. So this is the actual, it will, with the help of ring, it will fit on your camera macro lens and it will fire, and the control is from the controlling unit, and this is the entire one unit. I am using this flash, this is Nikon R1C1. The beauty and the best feature of this flash is that this is wireless. These all flash are wired. So up to certain limit, you cannot remove the, even in this, you cannot move the flash heads. Whereas in this, I can put my flash heads anywhere and I can fire wirelessly, because there is a control unit SU800 on the top of the camera, and then this SB202 flash, tiny flash units which can be fired anywhere in the distance of 60 feet. This is Canon MT24. This is Canon's flash, but again this is a wired one. So these are the ready-made flash system, or you can make your own system. You can say Jugaad of the flash, or you can have a hot shoe flash controlled with the TTL cord, and you can put it front of the your body and you can fire. Diffuser, these days in India, rather abroad, there are many people or macro photographers are promoting their own flash diffuser, which is extremely important in a way to reduce the highlights or the reflective area, because in monsoon, particularly when you are shooting frogs or snakes or tiny insects, the raindrops fallen on that insect itself, as well as on the sideway leaf, are very much bouncing back your reflection, and then photo might look not properly good. So to diffuse that light, even in its the spider eyes or the frog eyes, if you get a proper soft diffuse light, so these diffusers are made. So these are some foreign brands, or this is some Indian brands. There are so many brands available. So depending on your flash system, depending on your gear, depending on your usability, you can go for any of these, and then you can create very soft and diffuse images. So guys, this is end of this the presentation. Now, if you have any queries or if you want to discuss something, we are open for this.
It was a really amazing session, Yuvraj sir. I'm sorry for the disturbance caused due to annotations.
No, that is purely okay, because sometimes it is unknowingly happened, so it is purely okay. That's
so. There were lots of things that we came to know about photography in your talk, and it was definitely insightful for all of us. So some of them have posted the questions here. I'll just read it out for you. Let me scroll through them. Okay, so Ritwik asks, sir, how to find spiders or macro insects if you are in jungle or in a normal environment?
this is a little bit off topic question, but still I will answer. If you are going for, say, macro photography or any nature trail, if you are going with some expert, then it will definitely help initially. So they will find out you for you, because they are expert, they are going in the forest, they know the forest, they know the habitat, they know what kind of species to look for, what kind of species available in that particular season. So they will do job for you, and when you are done 2, 3, 4, 5 nature trails with them, any expert, then slowly your eyes will be say trained enough that you can spot butterflies and insects and spiders very well. So it is not that we have some special equipment, like I showed some flash to you and then we see some special spider which you cannot see. So you will definitely try to locate those kind of spiders or any tiny insects in forest, but initially you need some hand holding. So I will suggest that better you go with somebody who is expert in the field or macro photography or in biodiversity and in particular that topic. Suppose if you want to shoot snakes, so you go with some snake expert who is very good in that topic. Or if you want to shoot spiders, or somebody is good in spiders, so he can identify the spider, he can spot the spider, he can know there are the tree spiders and there are arboreal spiders and there are ground spiders and there are tarantulas who are say trunk dwelling or say on a cliff or whatever. So you have to go with them initial stage.
Thank you, Yui. It was an amazing session today. Really loved it. I learned quite a bit myself today as well, especially about lighting. What I'm going to request the audience is, we will not be addressing the questions related to general macro or species. We will stick to the questions that are related to today's talk. In case you have any doubts about basic macro photography, we would be uploading a video in the next 3 days on our channel, Journey Explore, which Apoorv had done. The video would be called Macro Photography for Beginners. So I think a majority of your doubts would be solved there. And if you still have any doubts, you can always post a comment on the video. It will be on our YouTube channel, Journey Explore. Apoorv, I hand over the session to you to continue with the relevant questions for today. Thank you.
Yeah, sure. Thank you. So, sir, next question is from Anish. He asks, sir, what are your thoughts on ethics of using flash for macro photography? As this is often going ongoing debate, does the use of flash, especially at night, dazzle or harm the insect in any way?
Really, this is very ongoing debate on this. Basically, yeah. Everyone try to understand that human eyes, the eye system, the retina system is altogether different in the animals, birds, and specifically in insects. Insects have a compound eye. Say dragonfly have 30,000 lenses in its eye, and they have simple eyes as well as compound eyes. So their eye system is altogether different. So you don't have to think about that they will harm the insect or the whatever the specimen you are shooting, say a snake or something. So don't think about that and try to shoot whatever way you want. Another point of, from the point of your hardware, your DTL flash is equipped how much amount of light is required. So it is very less light is thrown, which is sufficient for the illuminating that subject. It is not, unless you are using a manual flash system, but if you are using a good TTL flash system, so it will emit only the amount of flash required to illuminate your subject, depending the setting you have kept, or it is taking automatically through the lens TTL. So that is the thing. But the insect eye system is altogether different than the human system. So if you fire a flash on a human face, and if you fire a flash on a snake or frog or insect or butterfly, it will definitely a different effect on that. So do not hesitate, use your flash. And it is proven in the science. You will find so many papers on the internet that it is proven. Next.
So I think, Anish, that answers your question. Next question is from Stephen. Why is the background black while using flash? Even when you clicked in the day, the bubbles on the web.
Yes, when I use a high aperture, say 16-22, the idea is that to eliminate the background, because in macro, when the insect is sitting on a branch or say leaf litter, the immediate next twig or the leaf is obstacle in your background. It is not like bird, because in bird there is a huge clear bokeh behind your scene or your in your mammals also. It is not like in a mammal, and most of the time your insects are sitting on the ground, so immediately there will be pebbles or leaf litter, branches, twigs. So you have to eliminate that. So you have to fire a flash with higher depth of field. To get that higher depth of field, you have to fire a flash with higher F number, say 18-22 or even more than that. So your immediate background will become a black and your main subject will pop out. So that is the main idea behind it. So because you have to give focus to your subject, that your viewer will only see the subject, not the cluttered background. So that was the idea behind it.
Right. So I hope, Stephen, that answers your question. Next question is, by Viral. How do you use diffuser on Nikon R1 C1 twin flash system? Do we need two diffusers?
Yes, of course. I mean, how many flash heads you are using? So that many diffusers you have. Sometimes I use 5 flash together also. So I need 5 diffusers on my each flash head. So that depends how much light setup you have to do. But if you are using a single head flash, so you need one diffuser. If you are using a twin flash, then you need a twin. If you are using 3, then 3.
I hope that answers the question. Next question is by Pawan Kumar. Flashes fire at speed faster than 1/1/4000 of a second. So no flash doesn't harm you. Okay, this is more of a comment. So no flash doesn't harm or disturb insect. Some might get startled at first flash, but they get used to it. So insects usually get used to it after the flash is fired. This is what Pawan Kumar says. Next question is by Jimmy Shroff. Can you use a regular flash, example Godox V860, for example?
Yes. All these flash are normal only. I am using, because I am a hardcore macro photographer, so I am using this flash specifically for macro photography. But all these Godox 685-2 or even Nikon 700, Nikon 900 or Canon 430, those are normally normal flash, which is used for say human photography or function photography or for model photography. Same flash can be used for your macro photography, but use of some diffuser, because those are a powerful flash. Say your 685 Godox is a range of 120 meters, and in macro you are shooting at 3 feet, so the flash intensity is higher. Of course, those are TTL flash, so it will emit a limited scope of light, but still, if you want to diffuse that light, you can use any diffuser on it, which is practically available on Amazon right from 200 rupees to 5000 rupees. Depending on your usage, you can use that. But you can use the same flash for your model photography, for your normal human photography, and then for macro photography also.
Okay, so I hope that answers your question. Next question is by Amit Mahajan. Amongst the various diffuser materials, which one is your favorite and effective for macro photography?
See, particularly there is no fixed diffuser material for any flash. Okay, because depending on subject, the diffuser material for spider will be different from a diffuser material for a frogs or maybe for butterflies or not, because every insect or every living thing has a different skin system. Frogs are always very slimy with wet. Your snakes are with a shiny skin. Moths are with a drab colors. So no specific diffuser material will give you a exact details. You use a, say, brand 1 diffuser on a snake, it will give you good results. but same diffuser will not work on a butterfly or may not be on a spiders. So you have to think about differently. So there is no specific material available for diffuser. There are all-in-one which suits most to you or what kind of photography you are in, that you have to choose that. I frankly use, you have seen my photo, I use my white socks as my diffusers. It is not anything material, but that suits me, so that's okay with you. So it is not that it will suit you or your flash system or your liking. Next.
Right. So I hope that answers your question. Next question, I just want to ask questions that are relevant to today's topic, that is how to use flash creatively. If you have any questions that are technical or you need any support while using flash, then please you can ask that. Till then, till the point you are typing your questions, sir, I want to ask you, what type of diffuser do you recommend to a photographer who is shooting small and large subjects at the same go? I know that there are diffusers that are specially for insects and some other, there are big diffusers for snakes, but is there any way to shoot and get proper diffusion and proper lighting using any setup for?
I'm not able to heard last two sentences.
Okay, I think there's some network issue with Apoor. So his question was, what diffusers do you suggest when people are shooting both small and large subjects?
See, basically, as I told you already, that what kind of flash you are using for your system, that is first most important, because I am using, say, tiny flash. So my diffuser system is different than user if you are using a Canon 680 or whatever kind of flash. So that you have to think that what kind of flash you are using, and then you have to invent or you have to go for that flash. That is first. Then same flash system can be used on, say, insects as well as the frogs as well as the snakes also. Again, there will be different effects. So no one flash diffuser can perform same effect on all the subjects. So that is nothing. So you have to invent again and again, or rather you have to go for 2-3 different diffuser also, and one single flash, but diffuser will be different.
Right.
Just like in add-on facilities. These right. days, I think Godox V1 and the Profoto A1 have that round flash, and they have add-on, say, magnetic attachment fixing on that. So you can do, depending on what kind of photography, what kind of subject you have, you can change on the accessory. So frankly, that is the ideal solution on, because no flash can give you 100% satisfactory result with all the subjects.
Right. I think, Apoor, that answers your question. The next question for you, Yui, is by Ashok. Which is a very good question, actually. He asks you, how do you know how much light is to be used in a particular image? Like, for example, if you're using backlight, how do you compensate it? Do you use two flashes or more? And how do you decide how many flashes to use, especially with your R1C1?
Sir, ye to aajkal bahut aasan hai. You are using digital photography, so your camera is equipped with the LCD screen, and you click one photo and then you can see immediately. When I started photography in 1992, when there were film cameras and no screen was available, you have to think and you have to sense and you have to judge and you have to read that light depending on the availability and the subject, you have to shoot. And there is a limitation of the roll exposure also, because there is only 36 film or 36 exposure in that film. These days, it is pretty much easy that you can click on one photo, you see that if there is a excessive light, if there is a less light, if there is a need of change of light direction, you have to do. Now, I have seen you that praying mantis images. The praying mantis was very tiny, less than say 1 centimeter, and it is wriggling continuously. So suppose I click one good image, within second that insect moves and my entire light setup is vanished. I have to rearrange everything. So it is no hard and fast rule that I will fire from say 45 degree, I will fire from the some back of the insect, I will fire from the... You have to do all this jugglery on the field itself. Now imagine the same praying mantis is purely with the green color, the effect is different. If the praying mantis is black with the orange semi-transparent legs, just like that link spider, the effect is different. So again, depending on the subject you have, you are shooting, that setting of the light is creatively what you think about that. So you have to try again and again to get creative. If you're firing from the front, then it will TTL. Whatever you think, aperture with F8 or something you get, you will get proper depth, you will get proper lighting, you will get image. But if it is creative, then you have to do a lot of juggling because that insect is not stable. If you are doing this in, say, with a model photography in studio, you can ask that model to keep steady or you keep posing again and again. In wildlife, it is not possible. So it is frankly very difficult. And then you have to do a lot of permutation combination and frankly lot of failed attempts also. Yeah, next.
So next question for you, Yui, is by Mishroom. I'm sorry if I'm pronouncing your name wrong. The first question I don't think is relevant to yours, but the second question is definitely relevant to today's talk, which is how can someone create drama with only using one flash?
Definitely, it is not that you must have a two flash system or three flash system. No, you can have create a drama with single flash also. Now think this scenario. Normally your flash is sitting on your top of the camera. Normally, either the inbuilt flash or whatever the overhead flash. Think about that your flash system is equipped with the wireless and your camera system is wireless, so you can remove this flash and keep it behind the subject, left side, right side, back side. So only one flash, because if you are shooting in a daytime, there is a ambient light, that is sun is giving you a light, sufficient light. Now you are giving a support and different light system, so you can place anywhere and it will give you mind-boggling results. Believe me, only one light. Because if you are looking for some model photography, there is a specific zone of that single light photography, yeah, one light photography. They use only one strobe on a model photography. So same here, we are using only one photo, or rather one flash for your photography. Now, how to place that flash is very much important. If you are putting on a head of your camera, it will be giving you the front lit image only. If you want to think about the side lit, back lit image, one flash is sufficient, more than sufficient, and it will give you tremendously creative images. Related to your earlier question also, how many flash you can think of. So only one flash, only two flash, sometimes five flashes also, because if the subject, because if the tail of that snake is also important, if the other part of that wing of that insect is really important, so I need to illuminate that with the different flash. I need to illuminate the head with the different flash. So that time I need a more flash heads. But it is not that only with the multiple flash head I can create a creative lighting system. Only one flash can do the job. Only thing, you have to remove that. Normally, logon ka 90% belief is that you have to put your flash on your camera and you have to fire. No. Think differently. Remove that flash. Of course, if your flash and your camera is equipped with that feature, wireless feature. Okay. So you can place anywhere and you can try. That is beautiful results it will render. Yeah, next.
Right. Thank you, Yui. The next question is by Amit. Can you tell us how you shot the largest wrinkle frog, placement, angle of light, etc.?
Yes, I have to literally sleep on the ground and at a say 40 degree or less than that 35 degree, I have to fire my flash. So it will not reflect from the water surface. It will penetrate the water, give illumination to the frog, and it will do. Again, if you are... say equipped with the digital camera, you can fire and you can see if there are any reflection back. So you can change your angle of shooting. And then it is not very difficult, but you have to think that normally your flash will go bounce back from the water surface and it will give you a reflection. So you have to think that, and then you can act accordingly. It is very simple. It's not that there is some calculation or something. No, you have to just try it. Within 2-3 attempts, you will get such results.
So Amit, I think that answers your question. The next question is by Jimmy. Which is, besides aperture and use of light, does stacking also help? And do you do it?
No, I don't use stacking because I think it's non-natural and I prefer natural. So stacking, I don't prefer. Frankly, stacking is done by all the European or the other Western countries photographer. They use dead insect. They use in home table setup. They create multiple focusing points and then stack or those sandwich those images, which is normally done in stargazing photography kind of thing. I don't like clicking the dead insect unless it is some documentation purpose. So there is a big no-no for me for first reason. Second reason, I think if there is a shadow and highlight that is more natural, and in nature there is no everything sharp, there should be some defocus part in your subject, then only it will give you a proper result. But again, then that is an art and that is a science. So for learning that, you can very well do that. But personally, I don't prefer, because first my priority is I will prefer always to shoot live insect in wild. So for me, it is no, no. But definitely many people are doing in a field itself. They are doing very well. So it's personal choice. Next.
Thank you. I think that answers your question. Okay, now I think this is the last question for the day, which is by Sachin, which is, which are the recommended remote triggers for Canon and Nikon that you prefer?
That depend on the usage of your application. If you are doing for just to say macro photography, is the single trigger is required, then very common or which is cheap 700-800 rupees Canon or Nikon remote is useful. These days, frankly, many these latest digital SLR equipped with your smartphone connectivity. So even your phone can able to focus and click the image for you. So you don't require a dedicated remote for that. So that can be done. But if you are looking for the interferometer, so you can use Fotix or any other brand, which is normally used for your stargazing or multiple, time-lapse photography kind of thing. So you can create, say, 1,000 shots with the, say, difference of 30 seconds each. So for that...
Yui, sorry to interrupt. Sachin has written... he's talking to about triggers related to the flashes. Do you use any in particular?
Oh, my R1C1 is equipped with the SU800, which is inbuilt the system.
Right.
So otherwise, you can use a Godox or whatever flash system you are using. So any trigger which is having a capacity of group and channels and wireless,
right.
So that can be used. So the cheap and easily available are Godox and Yongno right now.
Yes, yes.
And Godox are very much
effective. Flash, you either get the triggers with them or you can spend separately. But for the brand specific ones, you get their own respective flashes there. Yui, I think we can take the last question, which is also related to your work, which is, how can someone sign up for a tutorial with you? And when are you planning on doing the next tutorial?
Normally, my Instagram or my Facebook page is I am uploading like this event also I have uploaded 2 days, 3 days back. So if you are keen to look my work or my sessions, then you can definitely connect me with my Instagram account or Facebook account, and then you can get to know about all my activities.
Perfect. So I think you can find Yuvraj on Facebook and Instagram both. That is how you can get updates about his upcoming workshops. Thank you, Yuvraj, for this lovely session. A lot of insights.
Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot.
Use in macro. I also thank the audience who have joined us today. My only suggestion for the new audiences who recently started attending workshops like these is you please understand the topic of the workshop and then phrase your questions. That would reduce the effort and the time by the expert who is conducting this session. Thank you all for joining. In case you joined the session midway, we would be uploading the video on our YouTube channel, which is Journeys Expo. Thank you. Thank you, Raj.
Thanks.